Everyone, this is Chris Dawson, CEO here at Arcimoto, here with I'm McKendrick with Faction. And we really wanted to give you guys the update on that press release that really talked about that partnership and what we're doing moving forward.
So one of the things that got us most excited at Faction is thinking about how you could right-size vehicles to a lot of the jobs we were trying to accomplish. And the two that we really focused on was going after micro-logistics delivery, and then also vehicle on demand, where you can bring a vehicle to somebody and let them drive it themselves. Arcimoto planned for this future. Mm-hmm. So I think when we first saw the vehicles, we said, wait a minute, these are about 80% of the way there for what we need. As a company that really focuses on doing driverless technology, you've seen a lot of our industry go straight to cars. There's a big problem with that, and that is that cars are built by companies that build millions of units a year. Changing their production lines is extremely difficult. And when we saw what Arcimoto had built, we knew that we could move very quickly. We knew it wasn't gonna be a 6 to 8 year program, it was gonna be a 2 to 3 year program to really get a vehicle that was designed to be safe, reliable, and could be made driverless from the chassis up.
Yeah, and from the very beginning, we were really chasing this modular type structure. We use the same thing at Atlas Motor Vehicles when we're moving through that. It's how do we minimize the total number of unique parts on the manufacturing line, and how do we modularize that whole manufacturing process? So what this allows us to do is to continue to build the Arcimoto down the line, just like we would normally. And then with just a small kit, we introduce the Faction equipment right in line without disrupting the manufacturing process. We're able to continue and roll and still maintain the quality and output that you would expect from the main line.
The Faction system really takes up a small footprint in the back of the Arcimoto, and we pull less than 500 watts of power, including the actuators that are used to control the vehicle driverlessly. And so the power budget was incredibly important, because even if some of the big name autonomy companies showed up and offered to license us everything tomorrow, we literally couldn't physically fit the equipment on this type of chassis, and it would probably flatten the battery in less than an hour and a half.
Yeah, and you'd lose any kind of function, right? So the autonomous vehicle would just be for the sake of being an autonomous vehicle.
We're not here to build another research project. We're here to build a product.
So another huge aspect with the Arcimoto platform is this right-sized architecture. And one, it brings our overall energy demands down, our energy budget down, which also means we need far less hardware to even start that path of autonomous integration.
And I think this was a shared vision when we first met the Arcimoto team. When you start thinking about electric vehicles in general, the electric car is actually not a very good solution. Most people don't know this, but 90% of the battery energy in an electric vehicle typically goes to moving just the chassis, not the person or the payload on the vehicle. With this class of vehicle that Arcimoto's developed, it's more like 50-50.
One of the aspects of the Faction system that I love so much is that power budget, right? And actually from an engineering perspective, we look at this and I want the best user experience, the most range, the most efficiency that I can get out of this. And when we look at other autonomous type platforms, we're talking kilowatts of energy that you're pulling off of my powered budget. And that's quite literally miles off of the performance, and that's a much worse user experience. But when we look at Faction's architecture, we're now talking about watts, not even a full kilowatt of that compute that's happening on board. So this is a much more manageable system to integrate with the Arcimoto platform.
One of the things that we did recently was the program to go ahead and make modifications to the steering system. I think the thing that really impressed us about the modular design of the vehicle is everything we needed to touch for a drive-by-wire system that could be done safely and to make sure it was highly redundant is basically encapsulated in the front clip. We've even made steering modifications together over the last several months that we know we can take to production and give us more reliability for high-speed driverless operations. All the electronics are all centralized up in the front. This architecture means that you can essentially take a driverless ready variant of this and marry it to a chassis on the same line that you're building your other variants. And that's unheard of in the vehicle industry. If you look at the urban footprint, the typical mission, it's 1 to 2 people, 3 to 5 miles. And I think one of the shared philosophies that Arcimoto's had, that Faction also subscribes to, is the car is almost reaching its useful life in urban transport. It's the wrong tool. And the future is gonna be blended fleets. And having right-sized mobility with the Arcimoto platform is a great starting point, but there's a ton of other possibilities that we can go tackle together.
Yeah, the modern vehicle really is just the Swiss Army knife, right? It does so many things and it does none of them well, right? And you just got this big, horrible thing sitting in your pocket trying to deal with it. Now we're dealing with this big horrible thing out on the road, right? And what do you do with it? Like, what most people do is they park it, right? Or they're like, oh, we're not gonna go downtown to go eat, right? Because I gotta deal with parking and everything. Guess what's really easy to park? I think we'll start seeing purpose-built vehicles in micro-mobility and mobility spaces where people start to realize, hang on, I don't need this 6,000-pound SUV and this big old pickup truck. Yeah. Especially with the different variants that we offer with Arcimoto, you can actually still get work done with a flatbed or a box truck or a Deliverator, right? And so now it's like, what do I actually use my vehicle for? Let's solve for that. And now you only pay for what you need, and you're not paying for all the things that you don't.
When we looked at the numbers, if you look at just the gig worker deliveries in the last, what, year or so, like 2022, it was 1.8 billion deliveries were done between the top three delivery services. And they're primarily using people who are driving around in internal combustion cars.
And then we look at the overall acquisition cost required to get something like that. Let's say it's a piece of capital equipment for deliveries, or even just your gig worker type delivery. They're still buying those used internal combustion, because forget trying to afford a full electric, even a used, right? There's plenty of Tesla used Teslas on the road. Still, that acquisition cost for that to then use that for deliveries is also out of reach, right? Where with an Arcimoto platform, we're well within that initial acquisition price. Someone who works for a living can actually afford it.
When you look at everything that we've done together on these vehicles, everything's been designed for manufacturing. Everything's been one step further towards scale. And that's real. I think together, we're getting primed to do that now.
So naturally, with this partnership that we've announced, we've taken an equity stake in each other's companies, right? One, we both believe in each other's platform. We also see a very successful future with us working hand in hand. And you know, though we've been working very closely together over the last 2 years, this really solidifies the availability, and frankly, an investment in Arcimoto is an investment in Faction now. And this truly is that rocket ship that's getting ready to take off. I know you guys didn't hear me say it, but here are the first murmurings of the engines kicking up. And then now it's time to get and join the ride.
I think we may be one of the few companies actually working together even that has driverless systems on the road today that have license plates, the numbers on them from the factory.
Yep.
Because as a three-wheel, you know, electric vehicle, Arcimoto is essentially the leading manufacturer now. Yep. In North America. And we're probably one of the only solutions that could actually fit on this class of vehicle.
Yeah, and as we see all the other autonomous companies really starting to struggle, close their doors, focus on other aspects, focus on the design or the R&D side of things, and frankly, recoiling back and trying to figure out how to make it happen, we're out here actually doing it.